Starting on a new project to make a monster truck shelf out of a bike tire. Ripping down some boards here on the table saw using a 60-tooth combo blade. And then moving over to the miter saw to get everything all cut down to size. I have everything cut down to rough sizes here, not really knowing how everything's going to fit, but having a pretty good idea. I went ahead and stained everything. This is just simply for filming purposes, so you can see how everything goes in. I wanted to customize one of the boards, and I'm going to use the StepCraft M1000 CNC to do that. I'm using a bit here just to line up the edge, because the edges on the other pieces have already been rounded over, so I needed a square edge to reference against. Making sure that everything is level with the table on this 90 degree clamping jig, and picking up the 1/16 inch downcut bit to carve in Eli's trucks. He is obsessed with monster trucks, and that's what this shelf is going to hold. The downcut bit does a really nice job cutting through the masking without tearing anything out, so we're left with a really nice finish on there that we can just remove from the CNC and begin painting. The downcut bit is done, and we can move that off the machine and move it over to the workbench where we'll get that all painted. For this, I am using some standard latex paint. Nothing so special here. I didn't do any sort of sealing before, but once the paint's dry, I use a heat gun to heat up the masking, which makes it a little bit easier to pull off and prevents any sort of grain pull on there as well. We got that removed. And as I was testing pieces here, I noticed that there is a bit of a point here on the edge that as it pokes through the tire. So we need to make those less sharp. Had I known about this issue before, I would have been able to actually cut the boards on the CNC, but I didn't. So this jig's definitely gonna save me some time. Basically, this is going to let me put the boards in place. We'll be able to round those corners, make it a nice soft fit for the tire so it doesn't poke through so much. So we're gonna use a 1/4 inch flush trim bit to flush trim to the template. That template fits really nicely over each one of these shelves, and I'm able to get that pulled off and on and round both edges at the same time. This was a really quick process, something that definitely made this whole thing really easy to do on all of the shelves that we had. So we just went through and did that on all of those. Those edges are still a little sharp, so we'll soften those with a roundover bit. This is a large 3/8 inch roundover, and I did that in a couple passes. That way it didn't take too much at a single time, and it did a really nice job leaving a clean cut there. The bike tire came all folded up, and it has a bunch of fold marks in it, so I needed to make some sort of backer. So I'm just going to use some 1/2 inch plywood and make a little spot for the tire to sit in. And then that provides a backer to help keep the tire nice and circular while I'm trying to get everything all done. So again, we're just using that StepCraft M1000 CNC to do that with just a 1/4 inch downcut bit to cut out the profile. So then we'll get that flipped over and get it released from the piece with a multi-tool just to cut through those tabs. We can remove that and we have our piece ready to go. So we'll get all of that stained, that way everything looks nice and consistent. And we'll also get the shelves stained where we had cut through them before. I'm using General Finish's Spiced Walnut for this, and for that backer board, I used General Finish's Colonial Maple. It gives a really nice look and stains nice and evenly. So now we can get the tire all put on. Basically, I'm just going to drill through that tire and put screws into our backer board. So that got all secured down, and I was able to get everything stretched over. The shelves I'm able to put in, I made a little jig to help get everything spaced evenly, and then put screws through the front. I used black screws, and you can hardly even tell that they're there unless you're really looking for them. So then I did the same thing for the top shelf. Now I need to get those screwed in on the backside. The first one is the most critical one. I used a square to make sure that I got everything all screwed in correctly. Then I can just flip those jigs over. And that makes sure that everything is in the same position. And I measured up to ensure that I hit those shelves. I clamped everything in place. I'm using a 55227 Nomar countersink bit to help screw everything in. Doesn't mark the back at all and drills the screws to the right depth every single time. It's a really nice tool to have. To hang this on the wall, I'm going to use a French cleat, so I angled the blade over to 45 degrees, got that cut, and now I have the two sides of my French cleat ready to go. Since I used 1/2 inch plywood, I don't have a lot of room to mess with getting these screws in there, so I'm using a tapered countersink bit here to help screw everything in. That way I have a nice bite at the bottom, and I can use those shorter screws and still make sure that everything is nice and secure. I added a spacer on the backside, and we have this piece ready to go. I'm super happy with the way that this project turned out. My son's going to love it. Let's go give it to him. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Have a great day, everyone.
This bunch is a pizza.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe right over here and click right over here for more great videos.